So let me ask you something. Have you ever really thought about what your pension is doing right now? I don't mean the number you see on a statement. I mean the actual cash. Like, where is it? Did you know it could be out there helping a startup invent a new medical device? Or maybe it's funding a huge wind farm hundreds of miles away. It's true. That little bit of money you save every month, well, it's part of something absolutely massive. And honestly, it's pretty incredible. Yeah, your money isn't just sitting in some digital vault collecting dust. No way. It's out there in the world, working around the clock in a system that, let's be honest, most of us never even see. So today, we're going to pull back the curtain on this hidden world. We are going to follow the money, map out the incredible journey it takes through the one system that powers just about everything around us, and that's the capital market. Okay, so at its very core, the capital market is basically like a huge, super sophisticated matchmaking service. But for money, seriously, it has one essential job: to connect two totally different groups of people who have exactly what the other one needs. It's that simple.
Here's the easiest way to picture it. The capital market is the engine that takes all those trillions of dollars in savings, money that's just sitting there, and transforms it into active, productive investments. It's like the circulatory system of our economy, right? It pumps capital from where there's a lot of it to where it's needed most, you know, for building new things, for innovating, for growing.
So let's meet our two main characters in this whole drama. On one side, you've got the savers. And yeah, that's pretty much all of us, right? We're the ones putting away our hard-earned cash for the future. Then, on the other side, you have the investors. These are the builders, the dreamers, the people who need that cash to turn big ideas into reality. And the entire point of this whole system is to bring these two groups together.
All right, let's start on our side of the fence. When we say savers, we're not just talking about you and me putting a few bucks in a savings account. It's way bigger than that. So who are these keepers of all this money? Well, the answer might surprise you. It's really just a handful of huge, massive financial institutions.
And you'll recognize these names. We're talking about pension funds, provident funds, life insurance policies, all that stuff. But look, these aren't just words on a financial statement. These guys are the guardians of our collective future. They pool the savings of millions and millions of people, and together they control trillions of dollars. This massive concentration of cash is what gives the market its power. It's like a giant river formed from all of our little individual streams of savings.
Now, this next part is absolutely crucial to understand. A huge chunk of this money, especially the cash in our pension funds, is what you'd call long-term capital. It's patient money. I mean, it's locked away for decades, right? And that stability is what makes it the bedrock of the entire economy. It's the perfect source of funding for those huge long-term projects. Think new highways or really groundbreaking scientific research.
Okay, so the collective name for these financial giants is institutional investors. Just think of them as the expert pilots flying this giant jumbo jet made of our combined savings. Their whole job is to navigate the super complex financial world and find the best places to land, the best investments that is, to make our money grow, hopefully safely, over time.
All right, so we know where this giant pool of money comes from. Now, let's walk across that bridge. Who's on the other side, just waiting to put all that capital to work? Who are these builders who need all this fuel to get their projects off the ground?
Well, the list of who's looking for money, it's basically a blueprint of a modern economy. You've got the government, which needs cash to build the roads you drive on. You've got the big corporations, maybe the one you work for, that need money to expand and create new jobs. And of course, you've got the banks that need capital to give out mortgages for our homes and loans for small businesses. They all need this cash to function and to grow.
Okay, so let's recap. We've got the savers with a mountain of cash on one side. We've got the builders with their big, ambitious plans on the other. So how do they actually connect? How does the money move? Ah, this is where the real magic happens. This is the core mechanic of the entire market.
This big connection happens in a place called the primary market. And the best way to think about the primary market is like the grand opening of a new store. It's the very first time, the only time, really, that these investments are sold brand new, fresh off the press. It's a direct sale from the company or the government to the big institutions with all the cash.
Let's just walk through a quick example. Imagine there's a company called Future Inc., and it needs, say, $1 billion to build a new factory. What does it do? Well, Future Inc. creates a formal legal promise, and that promise is called a security. Now, the managers of your pension fund see this deal. They like it. So they send that $1 billion over to Future Inc.,
and in exchange, your pension fund gets that security, which is really just a formal IOU. It's a simple swap, cash for a promise. That's it.
So when FutureRank gives our pension fund this security, what is that exactly? What kind of promise did we just buy with that $1 billion? Well, it usually comes in two main flavors. The two big ones you'll hear about are bonds and stocks, and here's a super simple way to tell them apart. When you buy a bond, you're basically acting like a bank. You are lending your money to the company, and they promise to pay you back plus interest. But with a stock, you're becoming a part owner. You're actually buying a tiny little piece of the company itself, which means you get to share in its profits and, well, its losses too.
And when you put it all together, you get this one really powerful realization. That money you put aside every month, it's doing so much more than just securing your own retirement. It joins that massive river of capital that flows out to fund everything, from medical breakthroughs to building entire cities to creating opportunities for people. Your savings, it's the fuel. So the next time you look at your savings account, don't just see a number. See the future that you are literally helping to build.